Just yesterday, I sat next to my wife while she went back and forth between tabs searching for a kid's facial wash. She had been at it for hours, reading blog posts, checking ingredient lists, comparing prices, and still couldn't find one that matches her checklist. Chemical-free, organic, natural ingredients, and under 10 Singapore dollars. Had I known what she was doing, I would have stepped in earlier. I pulled out my phone and typed in a single query into ChatGPT. Are there any kids' facial wash that are chemical-free, organic, natural, and under $10? Instantly, it narrowed things down to one or two options. One query, one clean answer, no detective work. Now, here's why this matters to us in SEO. My wife represents the majority of searchers today. They still search the old way, using short, traditional keywords like chemical-free kids facial wash, but AI search changes everything. People can now ask full conversational questions with all their intent packed into one query. And this is where keyword research evolves. Instead of just thinking in terms of short tail and long tail keywords, we need to think about natural language queries, search intent layers, and the way AI parses context. And if you are already considering this shift, you are early. AI search only powers a tiny fraction of the market right now. Full adoption will only come when everyday users, people like my wife, naturally start searching this way. So in this video, we're going to show you exactly how to approach keyword research in the AI search era you have probably never heard of before, because these are all coming out from here. Let's go. Now, unlike traditional keyword research tools where they provide you with the search volume based on the exact keyword, there is no tool out there that can provide you with the same data for conversational queries, because ChatGPT, Perplexity, and other AI search platforms do not share what people are searching for on their platform. So even if there is a tool that provides you with the search volume data for conversational queries, they are probably not accurate, not even close. So since you are here, we'll give you a way to somewhat predict the search volume of a conversational query. It will make total sense after watching this video. So stay tuned. Let's start with the first step. Now, in traditional keyword research, the first step is to brainstorm keyword ideas that your potential customers may be searching for. Some marketing teams will develop marketing avatars, which is a fictional representation of their ideal customer, to brainstorm keywords from the point of view of the avatar. But in the AI search era, we can do things a little differently. We are looking for conversational and situational queries rather than long-tail keywords. For example, you are in the business of selling dog food. Some dog owners are very sensitive about the health of their dog, and they may be searching for dog food that is suitable for their dog's symptoms. So the common denomination is the different types of dog symptoms. We could first go to, for example, ChatGPT and ask this, what are the common dog symptoms? And it will provide me with a list. And then you will follow up with another query. Provide me with conversational and situational queries associated with dog food, which is the product you are selling, and the listed symptoms that dog owners would likely search for on LLMs. And these are the conversational and situational queries that dog owners would likely ask for. What do you think? These are pretty amazing, right? Feel free to pause this video to check them out. The key is to find the common denominator that triggers people and associate the product you're selling with the common denominator, and you'll get a list of conversational queries people are likely to search for. But the problem is, the common denominator may not always be apparent and you might get stuck at some point. So we thought long and hard for you to easily figure out the different conversational queries that suit your business, whatever that is. And with the help of AI and carefully crafted prompts, we came up with this prompt, which is best used on ChatGPT. It starts with, I'm promoting a product or service, and we classify this as product. Always start with a please. Identify the common denominator that connects customer problems, situations, or needs back to this product. Then I'll give an example right here. And then break the denominator into logical subcategories. Then I give examples. And finally, provide conversational and situational queries that real people would ask online, group under each subcategory, that naturally point toward my product as the solution. So this is the format that I want. Feel free to use the search tool. And let's say that we are promoting a subscription box for healthy meals. We can add that into the placeholder and hit enter or return.
And in just a while, we will have a list of conversational queries that are related to our business. What do you think? Feel free to pause this and check out the output. Now, this can be applied to any type of business. Such as you're promoting your social media management agency, and it will provide you with a list of conversational and situational queries related to your business. Then a budgeting app. You see, we have identified a common denominator as well, which are these, and followed by the conversational and situational queries. It can be for a baby stroller, and you will find a common denominator, as well as the conversational and situational queries, or whatever.
Try the prompt out yourself and let us know if it works for your situation. You can find a prompt in the description. Don't let this prompt be the be-all and end-all. Experiment new prompts yourself to find highly relevant conversational queries to your brand or business. Now, looking for conversational queries is just the first step, and it doesn't get you anywhere. So let's talk about the next step. The reason why we are looking for traditional keywords through the conversational queries we have gathered is because large language models do not rely solely on the data they are trained on. They search for web pages that are related to the query they are asked. And most pages on a web are optimized for traditional keywords, so large language models will likely look for multiple keywords that are related to the layered search intents. For example, in my wife's case, the conversational query will likely prompt LLMs to search for web pages that target these traditional keywords. So as search marketers, we need to create content that targets these traditional keywords so that LLMs will look at them when those conversational queries are being asked. It makes total sense, right? So instead of guessing the traditional keywords or having the AI platforms tell us what they are, we should search for the conversational queries.
The best platform to figure out the traditional keywords is Perplexity. Let's search for a conversational query. I want to stop eating out so much, but I don't have time to cook. What should I do? And immediately, you will see Perplexity searching for answers from different web pages. Now, to see what traditional keywords you should be targeting for the conversational query, you just need to click on Sources and read the SEO title of each page. This page targets the keyword Meal Prep for Busy People. This targets how to stop eating out as much, and then Healthy Meal Prep Ideas. This doesn't matter as much, but here it targets Healthy Meal Prep for Busy People. Meal prep shortcuts for busy people. How to stop eating out. You can also click on the Steps tab to understand what Perplexity is searching for. Once you have identified those traditional keywords, you want to put them into a spreadsheet like this.
Do the same for the rest of the conversational keywords you have gathered earlier and figure out what traditional keywords they bring. Now, you might have questions like, why would I need to create content around these traditional keywords? People never really look at those citations when they are on the AI search platforms. They get the answer and they move on. That's a fair point, but the goal here isn't to rank on Google or other search engines or earn citations. The real goal is to associate your brand with your customers' problems so that when they search for buyer intent queries, your product, service, or brand will be mentioned. The key is, the more you appear across those traditional keywords that genuinely help your customers, be it in written content, video content, or whatever, the more likely your brand will be mentioned in AI-driven answers. So while the path to visibility is changing, the foundation still comes down to creating helpful, keyword-focused content that connects directly with your customers' needs. Now, let's talk about this. As we have mentioned earlier, there are no tools on the market that can accurately predict the search volume of a conversational query, and I don't claim that our method is accurate as well, but it makes sense.
For seasoned SEOs, I'm pretty sure you know what I'll be doing next. This is the list of traditional keywords we have found for this conversational query. We want to copy this list and go to the Google Keyword Planner. Select the Get Search Volume and Forecast option, and now you want to paste the list of keywords here and hit Get Started. Change the location to Worldwide by removing any selected countries or regions and hit Save. This really depends on the location you are targeting, but for this example, we will select all locations. And now we have the search volume of the traditional keywords. So how do we estimate the search volume of the conversational query? It boils down to the layered intents. The first intent based on this list of keywords is meal prep. So this keyword is about meal prep, this as well, this too. So we will not add those search volume up, but consider them as one intent. So it is 10K to 100K searches per month for the highest search volume of that group of intent. And then the second layered intent is stop eating out, and this has 100 to 1K. So adding the search volume of these two search intents, we have about 10.1K to 101K searches per month that is estimated for this conversational search query.
Does this make sense to you? The search demand of keywords stays the same. People don't just wake up one day and their problems go away. So before or after AI, the search demand will stay the same. It is just the way people search for things that change. And using that logic, we can make assumptions about the search volume. Now, keep a record of those traditional keyword search volume, because as people become more advanced in search, those traditional keyword search volume will go away. Anyway, to solidify your understanding, let's do another example.
So assuming that we have searched this conversational query on perplexity, what food supports senior dogs who are stiff in the morning? And we have found this list of traditional keywords. Let's copy it and go to the Google Keyword Planner and paste it here. Hit get started. And here we go.
Now let me pad the results.
And now we can see that dog food for senior dogs is one intent, dog food for arthritis is another intent, anti-inflammatory foods for dogs have similar intent as dog food for arthritis, the same goes for arthritis diet tips, so we can consider them as one, taking the higher search volume into consideration, and joint supplements for dogs is another intent. So for this conversational query, we have three layered intents, and if we add them up, it will be 21K to 210K, because the highest for dog food for senior dogs is 10K to 100K, then best dog food for arthritis combines these two other keywords, and the highest of them is 1K to 10K. And for the joint supplements and supplements for dogs with arthritis, the highest of them is 10K to 100K. So adding them up, it will be 21K to 210K of monthly search volume for this conversational query.
So we are considering search intents in all angles for conversational query to find its estimated search volume. By all means, develop a customer avatar to figure out the conversational queries. What I've shown you in step 1 is just one of the methods. And once you have done step 2 and step 3, you can pick the group of traditional keywords with the most search volume to target first. Scrap the traditional keyword research mindset where you'll target the least competitive keywords first, because the rules have changed. You want to target keywords that matter to your customers regardless of how competitive the traditional keywords are. But just in case you want to understand the context of traditional keyword research, you can check out this video right here that will walk you through the entire process. So keyword research in the AI search era involves identifying conversational search queries, figuring out the different traditional keywords the AI will search for, identify the search volume of those keywords, and estimate the search volume of the conversational keyword based on the layered search intents. Forget about the competition level, at least for now. So this is the method I figure out while showering. The best ideas usually come when you are most relaxed, right? Who else agrees with me? And if you want us to create a video to walk you through the process of creating content in the AI search era, then smash that thumbs up so that I know you want that content. Anyway, what do you think of our method of keyword research in the AI search era? Does it make sense to you? Is it practical enough for you? Do you have any other ideas? Let us know in the comments down below. Our channel is all about helping you grow your brand traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.